Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to episode 6 of season 2 of my thrift challenge series. I am back in Nashville. We went on vacation last week. We were in Florida in Seaside. It was really wonderful and very relaxing, restful, much needed. And if you watched last week's episode of the thrift challenge, episode 5, Jason and I went thrifting for some outfits for the beach. And so I was able to put together all of those outfits while we were actually at the beach. And so that was a really fun challenge. This week we are back in Nashville, and I just wanted to take a minute to talk about what's been going on in Nashville. While we were on our trip, we woke up on our anniversary to the news of a tornado or a couple tornadoes touching down in the city of Nashville and basically destroying a lot of neighborhoods and homes and businesses. And so last week we had filmed that thrift challenge in advance to all this going on, and so I didn't get to address this or talk about it in last week's episode, but I just felt like for this week's episode I wanted to start it off by just sharing our experience with the tornado and all of that. So we woke up on our anniversary, which was March 3rd, to a bunch of texts from friends just being like, are you okay? Is your place okay? And we were out of town. And so immediately seeing those texts, I got on social media and just tried to figure out as much information as I could from people back in Nashville. And it hit East Nashville, North Nashville, and Germantown, which is where my friend Malia lives. She was in episode 1 of season 2 of the thrift challenge. She's like my best friend. And so I immediately called Malia and I was like, are you okay? What's going on? And luckily her place was not hit, but the surrounding neighborhoods were. And so literally just like one block over, the entire street got hit. And so she sent me pictures as she went around town and saw it all. I mean, she could literally walk out her front door, walk down the street and see a lot of the destruction. And so last week, Jason and I had started vlogging while we were at the beach, but we honestly just felt like, I don't know, there's a lot to process. And so on our actual anniversary, we just felt really, really heavy from everything that had been going on in Nashville, and then not being in town to help and be a part of it was really hard for us. And so we even considered going back to Nashville and leaving our vacation. Like, we had literally gotten there Monday night and we were just thinking about leaving Tuesday on our anniversary to go back to Nashville, but we had already booked the place. And it was really cool because I feel like in all of the destruction and the chaos of what happened in the city, Nashville as a community has really come together and has put just huge efforts towards cleaning this up and raising money and being a part of the community that's gonna rebuild these neighborhoods and businesses. And Nashville's just so special to me. Like, I grew up here and this city has always been really special to me. And 10 years ago actually is when the flood hit Nashville. And so 10 years ago, Nashville came together for that cause. And so it's been really cool seeing the city come together again for something like this. But I just wanted to talk about what's been going on here. It felt like something that needed to be shared. If you guys haven't heard on the news or anything like that, that's what we've been all kind of going through. And it's been really heavy on just the community and the city. But I feel like there is just a sliver of hope and a silver lining to all of this. And it has just been really special watching everybody come together. But today I am out thrifting. It was supposed to rain today, but it actually turned out to be a really nice day. And so I drove about 40 minutes to one of my favorite Goodwills, and I just thought it'd be fun to get out of the house and thrift and take you guys with me, of course. And since it has been warming up, I think we're gonna be shopping for spring looks today. So let's go on in and see what we can find. So it's been forever since I have been to this Goodwill because it's so far away, but I forgot that this is the Goodwill with this sound. And it doesn't stop, so hopefully I won't be in here too long. I'm over here by the blazers. I just said I was gonna look for some spring looks, but I don't know. I can't not look at blazers. You guys know I love a good blazer. We're gonna try to find spring looks though, because I'm sweating in this top. This was a Chloe piece that I picked up from a friend at a closet sale. So I got this for like 20 bucks, and it's Chloe, which is really cool. Can't lie, I'm pit sweating in it. So I'm gonna need to find some spring clothes for sure. So I really, really love this. I know this isn't spring. I'm not gonna get it, don't worry. But it is a petite, which is me. All you have to do is get a little sweater shaver, clean it up a little bit. This would be so stinking cute. Maybe I should get it. I don't know. All right, so the only way I was gonna stop looking at winter stuff was
literally pull my physical body out of the sweaters and blazers aisle. So now I'm in tank tops, and I thrifted a ton of short sleeve tops and tank tops for the beach, but I kind of want a little bit of like a refresh for my summer clothes, because if you guys have been with my channel for a while, you know I thrifted a ton of t-shirts back when I started thrifting originally. So I just have a bunch of t-shirts, but I want to try to get some like cooler summer pieces than just tees. So looking for that. Gotten used to the sound, and it kind of isn't as bad the further away from the door that you get, so that's good. I'm looking through skirts now. I want to know, do you wear skirts during the summer, or are you more into like shorts? Are you a dress person, or are you a short person, are you a skirt person? Like, what's your summer wardrobe? Now I'm gonna look through short sleeve tops, because I didn't find that many tank tops, which is a bummer, but I have a good feeling about short sleeve tops because there's like 3 racks of smalls. So hopefully I can find something. Guys, I just found the cutest little handbag ever. Are you kidding me? This is so adorable. Yeah, I'm grabbing this one. It's like so heavy too. I'm trying to be more selective with the bags that I pick up though, because you guys know that I just got my dream Chanel bag. So everything that I'm getting on top of that, I'm trying to think like, would I wear this over the Chanel bag? And this little basket bag that I just found, I love. So I think that's just like a totally different vibe than the Chanel. But I'm trying to not thrift like a bunch of just like okay bags. Like, I'd rather get like a really good one and feel comfortable like I would wear it a lot versus just getting it to get it. So yeah, you guys should check out that video though, because I did an unboxing of my Chanel and I love, love, love it. And I would have brought it today, but I like to take my big backpack so I can throw like snacks and stuff in there whenever I thrift. Plus I can like hook up my camera to it, which is really nice. But you better believe I've been carrying that bag with me everywhere. All right, so this one is real leather. It's so pretty, but I don't think I would wear it that much. And I really like the basket one more. So I'm gonna put this one back, but I just wanted to show you all this because it's super, super pretty. I love the texture on it. This one is also really cool. I think it's like a laptop case, but it has this like brass closure, which is really pretty. So I found this little beaded bag, which is very, very on trend. I feel like everyone's been carrying like beaded little clutches lately. So I gravitated towards this top because I thought the pattern and the color was really springy. It would look super cute tucked in, but I don't know if this is really my style through and through, but aren't the little sleeves super cute? This little ruffle detail. So I really liked this one because of the neckline, but it is really, really big on me. So this is a no, but I wanted to show y'all because I thought this is like really, really pretty. And it is small, but it is so huge. So I don't know if that got like mislabeled or what, but it's not very flattering on.
So I just finished and I got some amazing pieces. I think you guys are gonna love all of them. If you've ever thought, wow, she shops for way too many neutrals, you will not think that about today's episode, because I got some amazing colors and textures, and so I am so excited to show y'all what I picked out. So let's go home and try it on. All right, so I just got home and I am so excited to show you all of these pieces and what they look like on. In last week's video, somebody asked where this picture is from, and this is actually a print of a photo that Jason's grandfather took while he was in college. And so we have a couple of these photos that we've printed out that are super cool. We're gonna go ahead and get into it. I think I spent like $36, but I got some really awesome pieces that I think you guys are gonna love. So let's get into it. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and start with the piece that, let's be honest, is the best thing that I think I've ever found. This is a vintage basket bag. I cannot wait to wear this in the spring and summer. How stinking cute is this? It's also really, really heavy. Like when I picked it up off of the rack, I thought there was maybe something in it. That's how heavy it is. So it feels really, really sturdy. It feels like great quality. I love this little closure right here. You like lift this off, and then the inside needs to be wiped down, so I'm gonna wipe the inside down. But the inside is leather, it has a pocket, and I just thought this would be so stinking cute for like events or photo shoots. It's not like a great everyday practical bag, but that's why I wanted to get it, because I have some really great practical bags, and I just thought this one was super pretty. It also has some really nice brass hardware on the handles, and it's just in really good condition for being a vintage piece. I just love it. I think it's so cute, and you guys are definitely gonna see me styling this on my Instagram. I can't wait to shoot outfits with this. First clothing item piece, I ended up getting this coat because it is from Talbots, and it's a petite coat, and I am 5'2", so anything that actually fits really well, I like to get. So this one definitely needs to be shaved, but I can just get a little sweater shaver and these little fuzzies will come right off. But I just love this color combination and this pattern. I think this is just a really fun coat to have, and it's really different than any other coat that I have. All of my coats are like a solid color, either brown or gray, and this one just has some really cool texture. So this is the coat, and I seriously love this. It is lined with like satin, so it slips on really easily over sweaters, and I really like the length of it. I think it's a great pattern. It does appear a little bit yellow in this lighting, but honestly, in natural lighting, it looks amazing. And I wanted to show you guys what it looked like with my new little baby, because I think the colors of this is like my whole aesthetic. It's very fall, very brown, very neutral, and I'm so here for this coat. So here for this look, and I mean, let's just talk about how these look together. So I'm really excited about this coat, and I wish it was a little bit colder outside because I really want a chance to wear this, but I might just shave it down, kind of clean it, and then store it, and then hopefully break it out next fall. So the next piece that I found is actually a piece from Madewell, which I thought was really cool. This is a little skirt. It's like a berry color. It has pockets, and it is an extra, extra small, but their stuff has been running kind of big, so hopefully it will fit. But I just love that I found a Madewell piece, because you guys know I'm obsessed with Madewell. Isn't this color just super pretty? So this is the Madewell skirt, and it actually fits really, really well, but I really love the color. I think it's a great length. I obviously need to steam it, but I think this is just super cute, and honestly, it would be great for the fall. I could see myself wearing it with tights, but this is what the skirt looks like up close. It has this nice little tiny slit on the side. I think that's just a really, really flattering skirt, and I love the length on it. Super good length, so it's not too short. Plus, it has pockets, which is always a win. So big fan of this skirt, and it's Madewell, so one of my favorite brands. The next piece is a really, really pretty top. This one I thought would be so cute, kind of tucked under like a crop. This one's from Ann Taylor, so it's very nice. It has this beautiful kind of draping in the front, so I thought that was super unique. I love just the texture of the draping, and I just think it falls really pretty. So when I tried this one on, it was just really flattering, and then it has this kind of like straight across neckline as well. So love this piece, and plus the color is amazing. All right, so this is the ruffled top, and I went ahead and I tucked it up underneath my bra. And if you guys want to see how I tuck my shirts and everything like that, and also my sweaters, I have an entire video that is linked down below. It's 4 ways to tuck a sweater. Works for t-shirts, sweatshirts, anything basically. So I used one of those tricks for this method, but I actually really like the way that it looks cropped. I think this is a really, really pretty fabric. It has a nice like straight across neckline underneath, and I think it just lays super, super pretty. So I'm excited to shoot some pictures in this top because I feel like this is gonna photograph really, really beautifully and catch the light nicely. The next piece is another colorful top, and this one is from the brand Moon River. I think they actually sell this at Nordstrom, which is really cool. So this is a linen top, and you guys know I just love linen, and so I think it's really fun that it's yellow. And it actually has this really cool kind of open back situation, and then it ties. So I think it's maybe a wrap top, like it ties all the way around the top, or it might just like tie in a bow in the back. Either way, I thought this was super cute, and I thought this would be great for the spring and summer. So this is the yellow top, and I went ahead and I wrapped it around twice. These actually kind of fold over, so you just fold them back like that. And then you could probably also wear it where you just tie it in the back. If you wanted it to like stay open, I mean, I don't know if this is correct, but it's an idea. So if you wanted to like not wear a bra, obviously you could do it like that. So there's a couple ways you could wear it. I really love the color, and I think it's a great length. It's like already cropped, which is really nice. And you guys know I love a linen top, so this is like a win for me. Love the fabric, super, super breezy. Honestly gonna be so great for summer. Once I figure out a bra situation, I'll have like a nice little open back. And then the last piece is really, really cool. So this is a dress, and I found this one pretty last minute. Like I was walking by and like caught my eye, and I was like, I need that. And it just so happened to be my size, which is exciting. But it's this tan dress, and it definitely needs a belt. So I need to see if I have a belt in my closet that will work with this. But I just really love anything khaki or tan. You guys know my favorite color is tan. It's my favorite color to wear. Jason makes fun of me for it, but I can't change who I am. And so I'm really excited to try and style this. I love that it's a dress, and I just feel like this could be really fun with like some combat boots, or like dress it up with some heels. But I don't know, I just thought this was super cute, and I love the pocket detailing on the top and on the bottom. So I need to find a belt, but I think it's gonna be super cute. So this is the khaki dress, and I really wanna find a thicker belt to wear with this because I think that would look a little bit better, but this is the belt that I have, so we're going with it. I love the length of this dress though. I think it's super cute. I went ahead and rolled the sleeves to give it like a super casual look. I would definitely pair this with some combat boots, but I really like it. I think it's super flattering on, and I think once I get a proper belt, it will look a lot better as well, but this is what it looks like up close. So that's everything for this week's thrift challenge. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's episode, and if you did, please give it a big thumbs up and leave me a comment down below letting me know what your favorite piece was that I thrifted. If you want to check out the previous 55 episodes that I have an entire playlist linked down below in the description box that you can check out all of those. You can binge watch them. It's hours and hours and hours of thrifting. And if you are new to my channel and you would like to stick around, I would love for you to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.